So I'd hate to be the first person to come up here and present and disappoint you. But Kevin said I couldn't bring my bike up here. I tried to talk him into it, but he just wasn't happy. So I'm not going to be doing anything crazy, but I'm going to take you on a crazy trip. In 2015, I was involved in a motorcycle accident in Fresno, California. I T-boned a car, I was ejected off my bike, flipped and rolled 100 feet. When I got to the hospital, awaiting my first nurse, when he came into the room, I said to him, "Thank God you're here, you have to get me out of here." And this is all while being covered in road rash. Bone connecting my thumb and my hand broke almost clean in half. Ligaments torn in my groin, ankle, and hip, and I couldn't feel my left leg. So as I try to sit up and pull the IV out of my arm and pull the wires off of me, he looks at me and says, "Dude, what the hell is wrong with you?" You see, what he didn't understand is the panic and the urgency came from the fact that I knew that when I got out of those doors, everything that I identified with was going to be taken from me. And I was going to have to face a question that I've been avoiding. If you lost the bike, what would you be thinking? Tonight, I'm going to take you through my journey of a man's emotional pain and do my best to serve you and why I believe we experience it. This pain comes from a need for significance within our authenticity. We want to be recognized for who we truly are, and a need for a meaningful mission in a man's life. So I know that there's a lot of pride in this room tonight because I can see it from my guys in here. Who wants to be significant? Who wants to be valued? Who wants to be respected? Okay. Most of us will do pretty much anything for this, and that includes prioritizing it before our own life. That's what I did. So when the nurse had asked me what was wrong with me, it was that I cared more about that bike than I did my own life. I used the bike for a tool for admiration to the world and to cover up all the pain that I had created for myself. That was until I came across this number here. Who knows what this is? Anybody? These are the estimated chances of you being born. 1 in 400 trillion. And I thought, whether you believe in science or spirit, this has to mean something. I mean, if the greatest odds that I am ever facing are just being able to be here, how can a bike be more important or more significant than my life? So if I lose it, I just want to cash in my chips and give up. So as much as I love the bike, because I love it, and as much as it served me, even to be here before you tonight, it was just a vehicle to help drive me to find out who I truly am. Leading up to that accident, I've been in pain for years, on a rampage of self-destruction. I was suicidal, a functioning alcoholic, I smoked weed every day, I was on antidepressants, had a serious digestional issue, and I had an addiction for affirmation from women. I literally didn't care if I lived or died. But all this was being covered up by me becoming one of the best stunt riders in the country, being in impeccable physical shape, smooth talking and a fresh haircut. I mean, come on, I'm the man, right? I'm the man. I'm doing all the dangerous things everybody wants to do. People are so impressed. But the time never came when I could look in the mirror and be impressed with myself. The danger, the destruction, the carelessness, the recklessness was the only time I felt safe. So why does this emotional pain develop in our mind? And if you think I'm full of shit, look at the man next to you. There's a high statistical probability that that man is in pain. So high that we die by suicide at a rate 4 times higher than that of a woman. Why is this not mainstream media? So my idea is that there's an unmeasurable power within us that needs to be directed. My belief as a man is a spiritual warrior with the hunger for meaning. When we talked about the significance and the mission, these days, significance is easy, right? Likes, comments, follows, right? But there's no meaning behind that. Mission. Everybody's on a mission. What does it have meaning? I have a very contrasting outlook on this pain. Not only do I believe it was a positive force in my journey, but I believe it was necessary. After all I've told you, the bike taught me the best lessons in how to be a man. To be able to ride like this, I invested thousands of hours. Medical bills, court cases, skip over that. Broken bones, concussions, and spent my last dollar many times. What I did with this bike, as you can see here, is when I went through the pain, I went back to it. That's how I mastered it. So I had the success principles in my hand, in my pocket, but I would rather cheat death on a daily basis than look in the mirror and ask myself, why are you drowning in pain? This is how strong this is for anyone that doesn't understand. Why are you drowning in this pain? Why do you feel the need to be medicated? What are you trying to escape from? And it was in facing the pain, again, that I gained mastery. This is literally the hero's journey, where the pain and problem are the best part of the story. I mean, imagine, let me paint you a picture. You're watching your favorite movie, reading your favorite book. The hero, strapping young man, on a wonderful adventure. He gets to the adversity, the villain, to slay the dragon. And he says, no, fuck that. Turns around and walks away. I mean, come on. We don't hear these stories, because they don't get written. It's when the hero realizes him facing the pain and the problem is his purpose. And the dragon was not the dragon. It was about him meeting himself. And when he conquers it, it's how he serves his people. I want to take you to a moment a couple years ago that I experienced that was my hero's journey. In 2020, I made a video about my why for riding my bike. It blew up and got hundreds of thousands of views, but it wasn't the views that got to me. It was a message. Thank you for your why video. Brought tears in my eyes and helped me understand my son's passion for riding. I hope you stay safe and I'm glad you found your why. Epiphany. So this was self-expression. I hope you understood that. But so was this. I shared the pain, I shared what got me through it, and I bridged the gap. And then I thought, and maybe I'm crazy, that was supposed to be funny. I mean, come on, I'm crazy, right? What if all of this was intentional? What if I was supposed to go through this? What if this whole thing was designed for me based on this number? There was a little voice that kept telling me throughout the ride, when I had no idea what was going on, keep going, there's something there. And I'm smacking the concrete, right? Keep going, there's something there. Keep going, there's something there. This was that something. Use one's experiences to the highest degree of others. Use one's experiences to the highest degree of others. This is a quote in the book Master by Robert Greene. When I saw this, I decided to make a commitment and a vow that I have a duty and an obligation to the collective to be an example of an unapologetic, authentic, mission-based man. And again, be an offering, be a gift, be a source for anyone that needs anything that I've learned along the way. I looked for a long time for a group that was discussing the things that I was talking about. I never found it, so I started. The One of One Men's Group, a safe place for a man to come to understand that his character, who he is at his core, is what's valued most. And we will only measure ourselves based on our level of commitment to pursuing our inner truth, going on our journey, and expressing what we have learned to the next. three things that I want you to take away from this tonight. One, you were born under a set of circumstances that will never happen again. You are one of one. So the value, the rarity, the significance, the uniqueness that you seek, the external world can't give it to you. You were born with it. And two, your power as a man cannot be masked, cannot be muted, and it cannot be medicated. It's too powerful. You will use it. You can build your life and everything around you exactly how you want and take everyone with you, or you can destroy. The choice is yours. Three, whatever your inspiration needs to be, let it be bigger than you. You have to go on the journey. The pain is not weakness. The pain is your purpose and your calling begging to come out of it. Again, you have to go on the journey. You have to face the pain. Slay the fucking dragon. Why? So you can be for someone what you need. And again, let it be bigger than you. This is my inspiration. I said I wasn't going to cry. If I didn't go into the dark and battle my demons and go to war with myself, there's a possibility that my son be a part of the statistic of a man that goes into the dark and doesn't return. So when he goes through his go-through, comes to me, this is the conversation we'll have. Jet. A man is defined in times when he has nothing, in times when no one is around him, and in times when he does things and gets nothing in return. Who will you be? Can you remain the same when all your beliefs are tested? This is your character. I know it may not seem like it now, but this is the best part of the story. Whatever that little voice is telling you to do, just listen. You are one of one. Thank you.